We're here at World Super Maroochydore with Jordan and Ryan. Today we're going to be taking you through a chest workout with the Bionic Arms. Today's workout's got a total of 10 different exercises. You're going to have to choose more manageable weights because your fatigue point's different with the Bionic Arms. We've just done all our warm-up sets. We're going to switch up the weights now, start lifting heavy. Let's have a go. Yeah, big stretch. It's always needed for control. This thing's relentless. All right, at this point, we're all pretty pre-fatigued on the Bionic Arm flies. We're gonna be moving on to Bionic Arm presses, and we're gonna be supersetting that with a traditional bench press. Ryan's gonna start us off. These lighter weights, I'm gonna feel real heavy. By now, Bionic Arms have really ripped my chest apart and pre-fatigued me. My chest is feeling pretty tired and exhausted. Pre-fatigue like this, drop onto something else where you get some other muscles, triceps and delts working in. My top end weight's not quite what it would be if I didn't do my pre-fatigue with the arms first. Still, these feel lighter than the Bionic Arms. And I know my bench press next week will be stronger for it. All right, we're done with the traditional flat movements. We're gonna move on to some incline stuff now. Ryan's gonna start with a Bionic Arm incline fly, which we can do on a flat bench. All right, key with this is, we're gonna tuck it in, bring it towards the eye line, the same as if you had your bench on the incline. Bionic Arm's gonna hit the pec in a different position. It's important to hit the muscle in a different position during the workout so we can keep it going. We just got done on the Bionic Arm incline fly on the flat bench. We've still got a little bit something left in the chest. We're gonna completely obliterate it now. Jordan's gonna hit us up first off with that Bionic Arm incline press on the incline, and he's gonna follow that off with a superset with a dumbbell press. Little weights, we mess with physics now. They're a lot further away from his body. They're a lot heavier than what you would perceive them to be. All right, these are ripping his chest apart at the moment. So get another one, bud, another one. Again, if you can. Nice. All right, we got a bit of shoulders now, a bit of triceps. That's what happens when you're not using the Bionic Arms. All right, but now in the workout, we're almost at exhaustion. We've got about one heavy exercise left in us. We're gonna have Jordan start on the Bionic Arm press on a decline, and we're gonna finish off with a heavy incline bench. Then we're going to hit a crossover, we're going to hit the big fatigue point here. The angle's more susceptible to heavier weights, that's what we've left until the end. So we've got something a little bit left to push. One more, you got one more. All right, let's get on that press. At this point in the workout, we've all worked pretty hard. Our chests are cooked. We're gonna finish off with three burnout exercises. We're gonna do a dip, a push-up to failure, and a decline Bionic Arm, also to failure. All right, get some right. Guys, after an epic Bionic Arm workout, we got through all 10 exercises. Our chests are pumped and trashed. If you want to get the same results, inventfit.com.au. Better results, less time, more concentrated effort.